absolutely needs to try and get 3 out of 3 here.
She does. The starting position there, very close. Used the whip nicely as she hit the squat position.
Takes the lead overall, 195 running total. Well, the bar changing is going to 107 kilos.
Nearly said that then, David. When she came out for that last attempt, her belt looked illegal. It looked too fat. You're only allowed 12 centimetres in terms of the thickness of the belt. And you can see there, she's just been asked to change her belt. So the technical referees have just picked up on that. That's going to throw a spanner in the works as well. She may be carrying a back injury, so that other belt may have been helping assist that.
So Margarita Machado for Colombia. Again, one of so many athletes, in fact, one of 6 athletes in the first half of the competition who failed their second and their third attempts. But Yulia Paratova, the bar going to 107 now, so this is that would be a 2 kilo increase. I'm not sure they've settled on this at the moment, because that clock is counting down within a minute.
No, they're wasting time, David. It's a chance to give the lifters a bit longer to recover. It's another tactic that the coaches will use just to allow sufficient recovery time.
And the bar going to 108 for Aisegurú Corban, the announced first attempt.
You can see here the coaches watching the scoreboard very, very carefully, because we are so, so close. All of these lifters are within, well, just looking at the weights now.
10 kilos.
Well, there's only 2 or 3 kilos now separating pretty much all of them, so it's very, very close. Next change.
So another change. Machado now is going to come out. Margarita Machado. This is the Colombian who we haven't seen much of for the last couple of years. And there you can see, if she was to get this, she would go into second place in both the clean and jerk and the overall rankings.
Oh, has to work so hard on that for a first attempt. However, coach has pushed her too hard on her first attempt. That's going to take so much out of her. Well, that's thrown a spanner in the works.
Well, the problem is that the weights were changing and perhaps the coach is not alert as they should have been, because I agree with you. That looks awfully heavy.
The weight that she posted at the weigh-in was 105 kilos. She's opted to increase that to 108. I'm guessing it's to try and stay with the rest of the competition and to stay in with a chance of a medal. The question is, has she gone that little bit too far? She's now under serious pressure with only 2 minutes to recover.
I think you've answered your own question there, because one thing I would say is that if she doesn't get it the second time, she ain't going to get it the third time.
Well, it's going to be a sign of a true champion who can dig deep, stay focused, and execute when under pressure. But yeah, there's no doubt that she's definitely feeling the pressure here. She would have undone the knee wraps there to allow the blood to circulate around the legs to help with the recovery, but with only 2 minutes to recover, there's not much time for that. Clock is now on 1 minute and 5 seconds. If I were her, if I was coaching, I'd be getting up onto her feet around the minute mark, so she can then get the blood flowing again. But she's got plenty of time still to come out.
Putting everything into context, the world clean and jerk record set in the Olympics last year, Zulfia Shenshanlo of Kazakhstan, a whopping 1:31. But this is a long way from that. But on a personal point of view, this is mighty important now. I really feel, Michaela, she's got to get this.
It's a better clean, much steadier.
And well done. And it was all because of that early clean. The clean was much better, took a lot of less energy up, and she saved the day and ensured that she's got a total. 87 kilos from the snatch phase being added to the 108 to give her 195. And by heavier body weight over Paratova, is a little bit lighter, she's gone into overall second place.
Can I also just flag up here that Kristina Jovu, who finished very late in the snatch, so was a silver medalist, she actually hasn't had that long to warm up. And bearing in mind these girls are all starting pretty much on similar weights, she needs to be ready. So my thinking is, when she went off that stage after the snatch, she's straight into the clean and jerk, no rest, no recovery.
So Peter Tanasan now for Thailand, 109 for her opener. This is for 4 out of 4.
Very nice overhead. Very solid.
And she keeps the happy sequence going.
Yeah, that was a superb jerk. Anybody looking for a textbook jerk, that was it.
So, Sapita, 18 years of age, so literally at the beginning of her senior career, although she's still in the junior ranks.
Very impressive, and well over double body weight too.
She is the new leader with 200 kilos. World record, by the way, is 230, so we're a long way from that. And now, Rosmeris Barbosa coming on for her first attempt, as planned, at 110 kilos. 6 in the Olympics. This is a weight that she's done on several occasions.
Again, having to work so hard on her first attempt. Ooh. Well, that's a telltale sign that she's trying to drive too early with the arms. As she dipped, the bar almost came off her shoulders and she missed time that drive. That's unfortunate. She's going to be in the same position as her teammate. Having missed her first, under pressure. Bar staying very close all the way up. There's just nowhere to drive from. That bar was wanting to come back down as she started to drive up.
So Kittima Sultanan for Thailand. Again, another lifter opening up on a weight that she planned, but of course the first half of her competition, well, it didn't turn out as well as she'd hoped. Left on 86 kilos, down in sixth place at the halfway stage, so a lot of work to do now in this second part.
Just keeping the bar moving at the bottom. Great drive to arm's length. Just had to take a second to steady herself, but that's going to be one under a belt. She's well in the competition. Are you watching what's happening behind the scenes there, David? It looks like Kristina Jovu has put her starting weight up to 113, just 2 kilos behind the Chinese girl. This is going to be so, so close.
This takes Kittima into second place on 196. So 4 kilos off the lead, but Miyake now out for her second attempt. This is a 5 kilo increase, so this would only take her to 190, having been left so far behind. But as we said in the first part, I mean, you know, she's barely a 53 kilo lifter, weighing in at 49.17. Well, none of that was textbook.
No. What a fight, David. What a fight to steady.
Yeah, but there was press out there on the left arm, and it was clearly going to be a no lift, I'm afraid. It was a fight, but it was the whole thing was messy right from the beginning.
Two lifter right on the limit there. Sub 50 kilo body weight. Attempting a 110 clean and jerk. That is well over double body weight. Well, Packford slipped as well.
But this is what she seems to do. When she's there for the Olympics, she's a 48 kilo lifter. The years in between, she's 53. But as you said right from the beginning, it's slightly strange being just over a kilo over the 48 kilo category that she didn't go for that.
You could understand it if she was naturally weighing 51 or 52 and dropping down to 48, but naturally weighing 49, really?
Yeah. Strange.
Hips have shifted to her left. It's going to put some strain on the back. No legs left.
So Paratova now left in third place at the moment on 195. One attempt left. The European champion struggling.
Look at that back position. And that's painful just watching. See, a little bit dizzy there, the bar was over the windpipe.
Rosmeres Barbosa to come out for her second attempt.
Now, kilo increase.
No, it's...
So I was looking at a different lifter there on the scoreboard.
Yeah, no, it's second a second attempt at the same weight. So, still looking for a total. She gets this, she goes to 195 and joins another couple of lifters on that particular weight.
Oh, that was comfortable.
And that's the lead in the clean and jerk and third overall. So good recovery.
Good recovery, but you can see how frustrated she is. She's wasted a lift. And with this being so close, that could have cost her a chance of a medal overall. Corrected the mistake, though.
Well, this is the moment, isn't it, now in the stage of this clean and jerk competition. What have we got? We've got the Turkish lifter who hasn't come out, and I wonder, the bar sitting on 111 for our opener. Yobu has yet to start on 113, Li Yayun on 115, but it's really close. I mean, there's 5 kilos covering everybody at the moment. And Miyake, now, if she gets the clean, she's got the chance to get to 190 kilos. And to be honest, that'll be a real disappointment. In Paris, in the World Championships, she was 53 kilo lifter, 203 kilos her total. Also in Antalya in 2010, 200. What do you reckon?
Soft right arm.
No. Not her day. Not her championship. I think it's back to the drawing board for her. This year, this competition does not count for qualifying points for Kazakhstan. It will. And she would, under normal circumstances, be a big point scorer for her team.
I think she'll be down to 48 for next year's Worlds.
So now, Paratova, can she make the progress? She's on 195, this is a 5 kilo increase. She tried it once, she didn't get it. This would be to take her to 200. Not to be. Paratova, who had an entry total of 206. And that, I'm afraid, has not gone to plan.
I never really got any leg extension into that. It's quite hard to get leg drive and leg extension in when you start with your feet so close.
Well, now this is going to be interesting. 110 kilos she lifted in the Mediterranean Games on her way to the gold medal in that competition, where she set personal best all along the way. 111 now.
First attempt, David, that's 3 kilos above the 108 that she originally posted. You can only assume that her warm-up's been going well.
Yeah, and I mean, if she'd have got that, it would have been 188 as a total, but she'd have still been 12 kilos short of the entry total that she put in.
That was nowhere near. That looked like it should have been a third attempt, not first. It won't have taken too much out of her, she didn't get too far through the lift, so you'd hope recovery is not an issue. 2 minutes.
Well, she's fortunate because it looks as if... Well, although it's down to 40 seconds, I think it's changing, surely. And
that is so hard, that is... Coben is following herself, but because another lifter was cool before her, the clock started. It's now gone back to Coben. She doesn't get the 2 minutes. The clock goes back to 1 minute, so she's barely had any recovery time here.
Just to reiterate, if she gets this, she adds 111 to 77 kilos, which would be 188, and that would put her inside the 15 kilo mark, and she would have a legal score. No.
I cannot see how she's going to nail this on the third attempt.
No, because the same thing's going to happen. Although, if nobody messes around, she'll have 2 minutes.
There's two other lifters that have 111 kilos down on a third attempt, so technically there should be two lifts before her, but I can't see Villa Barbosa staying on 111, having just done a 110, so she'll probably go straight up.
Well, Machado's coming out now for 111. This is her third and final attempt to give her 198, which would actually give her the lead in the clean and jerk.
She's okay, just frustrated.
But once again, the red on the scoreboard really building up now. Still waiting in the wings, Kristina Yobu from Moldova, originally these days for Azerbaijan, 113, her posted opening weight. Li Yayun of China, 115. And Coben now, this is quite simply make or break. She doesn't get this. Well, she doesn't get a total. If she does get it, well, you said living on the edge. Boy.
She must have a superb jerk to be starting this heavy on the clean. Let's hope we get to see it. Seriously hard, clean. Well, she does have a superb jerk, but when that clean has taken so much out of you, no wonder she struggled. That's a crazy call, David. 111 kilos. shoot the coaches on that one.
Only one out of six lifts made. That in itself tells a story, but a really disappointing afternoon for the Mediterranean Games champion and the Universiad bronze medalist of this year. 20 years of age, she has time on her side, but not a nice way to travel home after that sort of sequence. And I just think they got it wrong right from the beginning with the entry total of 200. They all put themselves under far too much pressure.
Completely agree.
Now, Tanasan, Thailand. 3 kilo increase. She's in the lead at the moment, so this is interesting. And 100% record to date, so I hope that isn't the commentator's curse. She's just got better and better as the competition's gone on.
Tempting fate, David.
I'm on her side. Had to work that bit harder. Come on, come on.
Steady yourself.
Oh, I'd give her that. I really would.
I would as well.
Some
movement in the elbow, though, I thought, when she tried to recover, head to the centre referee, but I doubt the side referees would have seen that.
Yeah. And the jury looked pretty stationary. I can't see any movement from their desk, so I don't think this is one they're going to overrule. So, the good news goes on. 5 out of 5. And Sir Peter, interestingly enough, now a kilo ahead of her entered total. So, Rosmeris, final attempt, 112 on the bar. 2 kilo increase.
Great timing on the clean. All the Colombians moving their hands out very wide for the jerk. Less distance for the bar to travel, and she's nailed that.
That's great. She's up to second place overall and the lead in the clean and jerk. Lips running out. Interesting. So just at this moment, it is Sapita Tanasan on 203 kilos who leads the way. Rusmeres Barbosa overall in second place on 197. Kitima Sultana on third place, and she's still got 2 attempts left. But now, let battle commence. Kristina Yovu representing Azerbaijan, 113 kilos for her opener. This is up 3 kilos from what she originally posted. Great clean.
Well, that's why she's in contention. Catapulted herself into the lead there. She'll sit now, she'll wait. The others are going to have to do something very special to take away at least a silver medal from her. She's now going to wait to see what she needs to try and take gold.
So Sapita Tanasan knocked down to second place. She's 10 kilos behind Yovu, but she won't be too worried about this. What she really wants here, 1 kilo increase to take her to 204, and that would be the perfect six.
I think this would be a bronze medal overall for her if she can be successful.
She's really in new territory. 2 kilos above her previous personal best. All depends about this. Can she get there? She can. One big last effort.
Oh, missed time, the jerk, pushing with the arms.
She may still get the bronze.
She may well do. She's got to go back and sit and wait now. It's the worst thing to do. I think you can see by her reaction that she is delighted, though. 5 out of 6 lifts on a world stage, personal best. What more can you ask for?
Yeah, and a name for the notebook, 18 years of age.
Incredible. Some experience she would have gained then. And you know, it's great to see her enjoying it as well. Yes, there's a lot of pressure, but to enjoy it is critical.
She stays at the moment in overall silver, but now Kitima Sultan, and the bar has gone up to 114 kilos. Now, this would take her to 200.
She's playing catch-up on her teammate here.
She's actually heavier also than Tanasan, which, if she wants to catch her, is not in her favour.
Well, that's going to give her a medal on the clean and jerk. She needs another 4 kilos, though, to try and take that bronze medal off her teammate.
Well, she's actually going to need more than that because she's heavier than Tanasan, who's on 203. Yeah, sorry. I was thinking she did get that at last lift, when, of course, she didn't. But...
Kitima Sultan, Thailand, is prepared. Przygotowuje się.
So, Lee Yayun, the leader by virtue of lighter body weight at the halfway stage, over Christina Yovu. This, of course, is Lee Yayun for China, National Games champion, in which she clean and jerked 122 kilos. Well, we're not worried about this. Not worried about that sort of total at the moment.
Easy clean, solid jerk. Catch me if you can, is what she's just said.
Yeah, new leader. 115 adds on to the 100. So 215, Yovu 213, Sopita Tanasan, Thailand 203. Those are the leading scores at the moment.
So if Christina Yovu has any sense, she will take a kilo more than Lee Yayun. Christina is heavier on body weight, so only needs 1 kilo more. So she's just going to play a waiting game now. Whatever Lee Yayun takes, I'm fairly sure Christina Yovu will take a kilo more.
But Kitima, putting 116 on the bar, Kitima Sultanan of Thailand. Now she's got 200, this would take her to 200 and, I'm just looking at this, 202, wouldn't it?
She needs 204 to take the bronze medal. Maybe she's looking for a...
She has done 204. She did 204 in December of last year in Eilat at the World University Championships. 117. So that's 3 kilos, but have they got this right or wrong? She is heavier than Tanasan. So this would take her to 203.
This makes no difference on the medals. Maybe put her into the silver medal on the clean and jerk. No, it's gone to 118.
Well, it would get, yeah, so, now that makes a lot more sense.
This is an attempt at bronze overall to take the bronze medal off her teammate.
And the lead in the clean and jerk.
But the message has only just got through from the back room to the front. Loaders are frantically trying to put 118 on the bar. The lift is ready.
Well, this will be some recovery when you consider that she missed 2 attempts at 90 kilos in the snatch phase. So she lost 4 kilos to the whole field in the first half of the competition.
Her best down is 116, so this is 2 kilos over what she's lifted before at competition. Oof. Well, I've seen lifters not get out of the way on jerks, at least she did.
to her. And again, a tie lifter with a smile on her face.
Well, that was a gutsy effort. Her teammate will be relieved though.
So that does mean that Sapita Tanasan, because of her consistency, those 5 out of 6, she was rewarded in the first half with the bronze medal in the snatch phase, and she's been rewarded with the bronze medal in the overall. In the clean and jerk at the moment, it's Ali Yayun in gold. In silver, Kitima Sultanan. In the bronze medal position at the moment is Christina Yobu. So I suppose you could say that Sultanan has got that consolation prize of a medal in the clean and jerk.
Yeah, well deserved.
Now, Yobu, 120 kilos, 7 kilos up. Now, this is high-stakes poker.
This is massive, a 7 kilo increase between first and second attempt. Previous best, 116. We're looking at attempt at 120.
Although she did do 126 as a 58 kilo lifter.
It's a different ball game when you're dropping a category.
Is it?
Wow, look at the leg strength there. Lost the weight, but managed to maintain the strength. Oof. Well, it was a gutsy effort. Now Li Yayun's attempt at the same weight, and she's going to come out on it. If Li Yayun is successful with this, I'm fairly sure that we will see Christina go for a 121.
So effectively, both Michaela and myself think this is for the championship, the world championship. No disrespect to Christina Yobu, she does have one more attempt. This could go wrong. Probably won't. Not after that clean.
So Christina needs 121 to put herself back in gold medal position. She'll have a go at it for sure.
Well, if she takes 121, so that's an 8 kilo increase, yep, exactly right, that's what she needs, being the heavier of the two.
Well, if successful with this, it's all down to China then. Li Yayun would need to be successful with her third attempt. This
probably saw Zlatan Vanev just a moment ago on the left there. Famous Bulgarian, there he is on the right, a famous Bulgarian lifter who transferred his workstation to Azerbaijan as well. I can remember him having one of the most horrible dislocations I've ever seen in Riza, 1998. Yeah, never want to see anything like that again.
Yeah, but he propped up on the platform, on the podium by second and third place.
Right, so this for the lead. Nine seconds, 8, 7.
Well, that was a very strong clean, better than her second attempt. Does she have the legs? She has, can she stand still?
Fantastic. Absolutely fantastic. That is a terrific recovery, and it just shows you how much improvement Christina Yobu has found. And that is a whopping 8 kilo increase on her successful first attempt, and takes her to 221 kilos and forces Li Yayun to come out to make her third attempt. As you rightly said, Michaela, it was all set up with the best clean of the lot. And
well, quite rightly so. Li Yayun only taking the 121. This is equal to what Christina's just done, but because she's lighter on body weight, this will take the gold medal on the clean and jerk and the overall total.
But this is only a kilo below what she lifted in the national games. So this is no gimme.
No, definitely not. This is a very, very sensible call.
Yeah.
Works a bit harder on that clean.
It's there. The championship is hers, and a second championship in 2 days for China. This time it's the women's 53-kilo title that goes to China, and 5 out of 6 lifts, all good. And by virtue of body weight, lighter body weight, as it was in the snatch phase, she takes the spoils.
Well, credit to Christina for putting her under pressure. That really was a very, very close competition.
So the 1-2-3 is China. Li Yayun, 2:21, takes the gold medal ahead of Christina Yovu of Azerbaijan, the silver, and the bronze going to Thailand, Sopita Tanasan, at the age of just 18, 5 out of 6 on 2:03, very much the best of the rest. There you can see the clean and jerk results, but still the total results to come.